Hello everyone, welcome back and thank you so much for joining us once again in our channel Mom's Nest. Are you that parent who often get concerned about their child's attention span or concentration? Do you think that your child just doesn't sit at one place for an activity or study for more than 5 minutes? Or you often get this complaint from your child's teacher that they do not pay attention to the instructions in the class? Trust me, I get to read these kind of questions every single day into all the parenting communities that I'm part of. And I was one such parent few years back. I know this struggle is real hard. So today, I have brought my top resources, the games, the activities that we can use even in this time of lockdown when we all are staying home. And you can use these resources to build the attention span and concentration of your child staying at home. So without further ado, let's get started. Now the first and foremost resource or game is puzzles. Puzzles are so important in building the focus and concentration in children. They are a multidimensional tool. That means apart from building concentration, they are also such an amazing tool to improve and develop the other skills of children like spatial coordination, gross motor skills, hand-eye coordination, problem-solving skills. A puzzle teaches young children about the concept of a whole and that each piece is a fraction of the bigger picture. In younger kids, puzzles help in development of fine motor skills. Knob puzzles, chunky piece puzzles, foam puzzles, or even floor puzzles with less number of pieces are great for kids under the age of 3 years. Word games like Scrabble and crosswords are great for slightly older kids. Besides developing vocabulary, these games also help build strategic thinking in kids. Rubik's Cube and Serpent's Cubes are another fun extension of puzzles. They help build patience, attention, and perseverance in kids. They also promote concentration, which is one of the main elements needed to complete these games. Now, if you are wondering that these resources are not available in the current lockdown situation, then I have the perfect solution for them. Now there are many such websites that you can see in the screen that offer a huge range of free resources like this one. This website offers online free puzzles. These puzzles are categorized as per themes and complexity levels. There are also websites which offer free word searches, crosswords, etc. I will give a link to all these resources into the description box for you to check it out. Now the second resource is one of my most favorite one, and that is mandalas. Mandalas are such an amazing tool to build concentration, and this I'm telling you with my own experience. The word mandala comes from Sanskrit and it means perfect circle. Mandalas are circular abstract design with evenly distributed patterns that create a feeling of balance and harmony. Coloring in mandalas enhances concentration in kids. It also improves their imagination and attention span. There are many websites that provide free mandala pages to just print and color with your kid. So you can choose them as per your child's interest and complexity level. Just print them out and use it for your child. Now, one thing we must make sure is we have to let them choose the designs that most appeal to them and encourage them to increase the difficulty level progressively. One important point that I want to make here is before we start choosing the activities or games to build concentration in our young kids, it is so very important for us to make sure that it is challenging to their brains. Now, kids by nature are curious. So if the games and the activities that we are presenting to them are somewhat not challenging enough or have an anticipated outcome, it is bound to get them bored and they will step out of that place to look for something which is more interesting, and that's what we call, we as parents call them as distractions. So to avoid distractions, it is so very important to pick the games and activities as per your child age and interest and something that is bound to challenge their curiosity levels. Our third resource is building and construction games. Building and construction games are extremely helpful in enhancing concentration and attention span of young kids. These toys range from as simple as building blocks to extremely complex Legos. Legos and Magnetiles has been my personal best buys till date. Lego is a wonderful way to improve cognitive thinking and creativity. They also teach persistence to kids. A beautiful castle or a tower can come crumbling down with one wrong move. It is heartbreaking and frustrating. Instead, the children again start building it again, showing persistence and determination. These toys are readily available on all the major online sites. They are slightly overpriced, but trust me, they are worth every penny. Dominoes are another wonderful open-ended toy to learn multiple concepts in a fun and interesting way. The last resource of our video is memory games. Memory games are a fun way to help children stretch their brains. A deck of children cards or a pair of dice can easily become a favorite game of memory. The magic cup game, draw a word on my back, spot the difference are few examples of such games. Playing memory games improves brain function, enhances attention, concentration and focus. So this brings to the end of this video. I truly hope that these games will help you in bringing and improving the attention span and concentration of your young little children. Now, a few important points I want to make sure you understand here is, number one, when you are presenting any new activity or games to your child, give clear instructions. Break the complete instructions into step-by-step approach. Second point is, do not divulge all the information to the kid. Let them explore it. From my experience, I've seen that kids are more capable of finding alternate ways or many ways of doing the same activities that we adults might not even think of. Another point is, do activities in short bursts of time. Now, we are talking all about increasing the attention span and concentration, but that does not mean that a child of 3 or 4 year age will sit through an activity for half an hour or say 1 hour. That is not going to happen, and that is an unrealistic expectation of us as parents to our child. So do the activities into short bursts of time, say 15 minutes or 20 minutes, and slowly see if the child is getting challenged enough with the activity. If it does happen, they are bound to be sitting through the activities and they themselves will be pushing their own time limits. If you have any questions or queries regarding this video or any suggestions to make, I will request you guys to please put them down into the comment section. I will surely go through them and will try to respond to them or make a video on the suggestions that you have given to us. If you like this video and it has helped you in any simple way, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. It really, really means a lot to us. And we will see you into the next video. Till then, have a great day. Stay safe. Stay at home. Take care of yourself. Stay with your family.